right? This is the rectangular coil, this is the rectangular coil, and this is called, what to say, phosphor branch wire, phosphor branch wire. Now, why we are using the phosphor branch wire? For phosphor branch wire, for phosphor branch wire, right, Young's modulus is maximum and rigidity modulus is minimum. For phosphor branch wire, Young's modulus is maximum, rigidity modulus is minimum because of such a qualities. As you, right, as you apply any force, it is not going to break. As it is elongated, but it is not going to break. Because of such a reason, phosphor branch wire is used. Next, soft iron cylinder. This soft iron cylinder is placed. This soft iron cylinder is placed inside the coil. Now, that soft iron cylinder is placed inside the coil. That soft iron cylinder is placed inside the coil. This is the soft iron cylinder. Right? Why? Because the soft iron cylinder we are using. Soft iron cylinder, electric permittivity is maximum. As it electric permittivity is maximum, it will allow more number of magnetic flux through it. As it will allow more number of magnetic flux through it, the magnetic field induction at the center of the coil becomes maximum. As the magnetic field induction at the center becomes maximum, then it will experience maximum torque. Next one, a small circular mirror. Here now, the small circular mirror. Right, this is called, what to say, small circular mirror. This small circular mirror is attached to the phosphor branch wire, right, in order to calculate the deflection in the coil. Right, there is another arrangement that is called lamp scale arrangement. What to say, lamp and scale arrangement, lamp and scale arrangement. In the lamp and scale arrangement, by using the lamp and scale arrangement and with the help of mirror, whatever the deflection can be measured by the small circular mirror. And next one, here there is a, what to say, phosphor branch spring is attached here. Now here, construction. Next one, working. What is the working? No doubt the current is passing. Current is passing. As the current is passing through the current carrying rectangular coil or rectangular coil, as the current is passing through the rectangular coil, now this rectangular coil is placed in the uniform magnetic field. The current carrying rectangular coil, this is called current carrying rectangular coil, is placed in the uniform magnetic field, then it will experience a torque. Because of the torque, that coil is rotated like this. As the coil is rotated like this, as the coil is deflected like this, as the coil is deflected, that deflecting torque, tau d, is equals to n I b, right, cos theta. For radial magnetic field, for radial magnetic field, right, the coil is always parallel to the magnetic field, theta is equals to, therefore deflecting torque is equals to n I a b, cos 0 is equals to 1. This is called, what do you say, first equation. Now this is called rectangular coil. This is the rectangular coil. This rectangular coil is suspended from a, what do you say, a phosphor branch wire, right? This is the rectangular coil, this is the phosphor branch wire. Because of the current, this rectangular coil is deflected, as the rectangular coil is deflected, then pass power branch wire is also twisted. As the pass power branch wire is twisted, because of this deflection, pass power branch wire, right, is twisted. Pass power branch wire is twisted. As the wire is twisted, suppose coil is turned by 10 degrees. This pass power branch wire is also twisted by 10 degrees. Pass power coil is turned by 15 degrees. Pass power branch wire is also twisted by 15 degrees. Now, as the pass power branch wire is twisted, inside the pass power branch wire, there is a development of restoring couple. There is a development of restoring torque. Because of the restoring torque, it try to regain its original shape. Therefore, here now, as the coil is deflected, then the pass power branch wire is twisted. As the pass power branch wire is twisted, inside the pass power branch wire, there is a development of restoring torque. Because of the restoring torque, then it try to regain its original shape. Now, here, what is the restoring torque? Then the restoring torque is equals to C into theta. What is C? Couple per unit twist. C is equals to couple per unit twist. For 1 degree, that is restoring torque is C. For 2 degrees, restoring torque is 2C. That is 3 degrees, restoring torque is 3 into C. For theta degrees, the restoring torque is, what to say, C theta. Therefore, whenever the current is passing through the rectangular coil, that coil will experience a torque. Because of the torque, that is, there is a deflection. Right? Because of the deflection, there is a deflecting torque, tau d is equals to NIAB. Because of the deflection, the pass power branch wire is twisted. Right? As the pass power branch wire is twisted, then there is a restoring torque developed in the wire. Because of the restoring torque, that wire always try to regain its original position. What is the calculation? What is the restoring torque value is equals to C into theta. Right? What is C? Right? Torque per unit twist. Couple per unit twist for pass power branch wire. C value depends upon the nature of the wire, the value of the right pass power branch wire. This is called, what to say, second equation. How many torques are there? Restoring torque is there. Now deflecting torque is there. In equilibrium position, right, deflecting torque must be balanced by restoring torque. Right, what is the deflecting torque? NIAB is equals to, that is, what to say, C theta. Or otherwise, therefore, I is equals to C by NAB into, what to say, theta. Therefore, now I, couple per unit twist is constant. N is the number of turns in the coil, it is also constant. A is the area of the coil, it is also constant. B is the magnetic field, is a constant. The total constant K into theta. Therefore, I is directly proportional to theta. Therefore, more deflection, more current. Less deflection, less current. Where K is equals to C by N A B. Therefore, this is, what to say, the principle. Now, next one. Here, you want to calculate the theta with the help of circular mirror and with the help of lamp scale arrangement, right? We can calculate the theta. That theta value is substituted in this equation. We can get, what to say, current, right? Therefore, galvanometer is the device used to measure the current. Whatever the current is going to be measured, that is passing through the, that is, galvanometer. As the current is passing, then the coil is deflected. The deflected can be measured by lamp scale arrangement and, what to say, circular mirror, that deflection is substituted here, then already we have C by NAB, then you are going to get the current.